I'm Jay Taylor. I'm the editor of Jay Taylor's Gold, Energy and Tech Stocks. I'm also the host of a radio show called Turning Hard Times into Good Times that you can listen to every Tuesday at the Voice America Business Channel. I'm here in Vancouver at the Metals Investor Forum. It is January 18th, 2019, and I'm really pleased to be with Paul Kuhn. He is the CEO of Avrupa Minerals. It's a company that I've been following for some time. It hasn't had a lot of things happening in the market, but I'm glad to say there's some very exciting things taking place now, and thanks for joining me today.
It's great to be here, Jay. Thanks for having us.
It's really good. It's a story. I like project generators, mm-hmm. but I like project generators, and that's what you are, a project generator, project prospector, that does some work themselves, that likes to take a little bit of risk, put some drill holes down into prospects they think have a good shot. And you've done that, and you've been very successful in coming up with some very good grades of polymetallic grades. And we're talking about in Portugal, the Avalada. If I get
all three are good. Oh, they all work.
They work. Okay. Yeah. The project in a belt in Portugal. Talk to us a little bit about it, what you've done in the past, and what you're planning to do this year.
Well, first of all, I'm a geologist. Yeah. I've been in the business for about 40 years. I've worked all over Europe and North America and a bit in Asia, and Turkey for 13 years. Mm-hmm. I've been involved in half a dozen discoveries, either as the geologist or leading the team or whatever. So between my expertise and the staff we have in both Portugal and in Kosovo, we're geared for discoveries. Mm-hmm. We do a good job. We're good at what we do. We're supported well by a financial team, Mark Brown, here mm-hmm. in Vancouver. So the two of us together give us a great head start.
Right.
So we're working right now, our main area is Portugal, in what is called the pyrite belt. It's a belt of rocks that host, as Mark said in his talk today, over 80 different deposits from Lisbon, Portugal to Sevilla, Spain. Mm-hmm. It's been mined since before the Romans. Mm-hmm. The first miners were probably Celts and Phoenicians.
Wow.
So this is a long, long, long-lived district. And we made a discovery, a massive sulfide, copper-zinc massive sulfide discovery in 2014 at Sesmaria, the village of Sesmarias, and we called it our Sesmarias mm-hmm. discovery. It's on the Alvalade license. In any case, we discovered a 2-kilometer-long zone of potential mineralization. And originally, at that time, with a lot of detailed work, we felt that the deposit was a vertical lens striking north-south. And we drilled it for that. And as Mark explained in his talk, our partners wanted to do wide-space drilling every 500 or 800 meters. And we did that partially because we thought it was a vertical zone. Mm-hmm. Well, we had to start working on the project again at the end of this year in order to fulfill our work commitments for the government. And I got a very sharp American consulting geologist to come in and help me out. We've known each other for a while. And he reviewed all the core that we had done and some of the core done by previous operators in a general view rather than a very detailed view. And what we came up with was a geological situation where it appeared that everything was more flatline than vertical. And this has made a huge difference in the way we've drilled. And we're doing a 5-hole program right now. I'd like to do 6 if we can raise a bit more money, but 5 is good. Mm-hmm. What we've decided in doing in this program is that we've lengthened the strike of the known lens. So mm-hmm. before it was 300 meters long and 25 meters wide and deep, we didn't know because we thought it was vertical. Now we're looking at not only 300 meters, we're looking at 600 meters of length. It's still 25 meters thick, but it's also flatline.
Yeah.
Or not quite flatline, but it's not such a steep dip. So all of a sudden we have a plate out there instead of a pencil line going north-south. We have a plate that's 400 meters wide, 600 meters long, and 25 meters thick. So all of a sudden, our potential for a 25 million or a 30 million ton deposit goes like that.
Yes.
And that's the excitement here. Yeah. And when we put out our first news releases about Alvalade, We said our main goal was to increase the size. This is before I knew things had changed geologically. We wanted to increase the size of the lens and then try to figure out how to high grade, or not high grade, but upgrade the actual tenor, the copper and zinc material. And so far we've increased the size, which is really good. And we've just sent samples to the lab. So we'll get some results in about a month.
Very good.
We'll put out a news release, hopefully about mid-February or so.
Could you give our viewers a sense of what the assays were, the early drill holes? And they were pretty rich, some of them?
Well, the discovery hole was a 2% copper hole over about 8 meters or 10 meters. That lens is still viable, but it doesn't appear to be as big as we'd hoped it would be. Mm-hmm. There's a second lens that we're drilling right now, which may be a continuation of that first one. But the big one that we're drilling was the third thing we found. It was the SES 10 hole, the number 10 hole that we drilled into this property. And this is the one that now has become very big. Its grade is about 0.5% copper. It's mm-hmm. not 2%. It's yeah. not so exciting.
But it's bigger.
But it's much bigger. And we're beginning to follow a trend of higher grade looking material. So mm-hmm. only way we're going to tell is through the geochemical assays. But we're hoping for tons, and then we're hoping to increase the grade. And at least we've got the tons so far.
Yeah.
So.
Well, it's you know, your company is a very small market cap of around $5 million
it's
bucks
ridiculous.
Or something
Sorry,
like that.
But
and so, you know, I always like to pick up companies that are undervalued, and I think this story hasn't been one that's been out there. How soon might we see some assays, you're saying?
Well, we're going to have some assays on a previous hole coming in the next couple of weeks. Mm-hmm. This is one from a previous project. And then we're going to have these assays in about a month, mm-hmm. I would say. I think also that we have to say that in addition to this really fantastic project, we've got an iron oxide copper gold project mm-hmm. just about 30 kilometers away. And our previous partner gave it back to us. Didn't have the obvious near surface huge potential that they were looking for. But we've got the property back. We've got some pretty good targets in a 20 kilometer square zone, and we're going to be working on joint venturing that this spring. Uh-huh. No holding costs at the moment. We've fulfilled our commitments. It's free and ready to go. Third thing I wanted to say mm-hmm. is that in Kosovo, mm-hmm. We have a gold deposit there. We discovered it also in 2014. And our partner there has brought it forward. We spent about 100,000 euros on it. They've spent about 7 million euros. Wow. They hold 89.5%. We hold 10.5%, and the property is for sale. They're actively attempting to not unload it, but sell it, and we'll get 10% of the sale price. So we have a possible cash inflow in the near future on that.
That would be good. That would keep your dilution down, also allow
We're
you
always
to,
looking forward
especially
to that.
If you start to have some real success at Avilad,
yep.
you can use that to help finance.
To help, that's right. That's right. And it's non-dilutive, and that's the important thing here.
Yeah. You've also had some interest, and I know we're out of time here, basically, but you've also had some interest, I think, from some major companies as well. There's some big guys that are aware of your project because it does have the kind of size and grade that potentially
they're looking for,
that they're looking for. So that could be very exciting as well.
Well, part of the reason we're doing this is to get the potential partner moving.
Yeah.
The other idea, of course, was it's good enough that we'll do it ourselves.
Yeah.
And the third way is if these other people decide they're not going to be so interested, we'll have some other groups that are talking
good.
To us. And I'm spending some time this week talking to other
visiting
companies.
Some people.
That's right.
Excellent. Well, Paul, this is really an exciting story.
We're looking forward to it. Looking forward to the good results on it. Thank you.
Well, we are. I am too. I'll be keeping my eyes peeled and reporting to my subscribers.
Well, I'm glad for that, and I'm glad you had us come over to this meeting. It's been a great show so far.
Fantastic. Thank you, Paul.
Thank you, Jay.
All the best.
Yep, you bet.